the trail, okay?
Yay.
Yeah.
Nobody filling anything.
Yeah. And then we'll edit together and make
Yay!
It work.
I like editing.
Put everything inside. You love it? You stand here and you tell me when, see how this tire goes here? I'm going to get it so I don't go off the edge here, okay? So you tell me, you stand here so I can see in the mirror. Stand right where my feet are.
So yeah, as soon as it hits the top of the thing?
Yeah. See how this little bubble's still over there?
What bubble?
So that bubble there, how it goes to here?
Yeah.
And there to be there. It's not there yet. So I'm going to have to go up a bit higher.
Okay.
Alright. That's all right, I can adjust it. And now it's just, see how it's there, but if we just go a little bit, it's moving, mm-hmm. which means that we can adjust it with the wheels.
Okay.
All right.
Now what do we have to do with the wheels? Turn like this.
We'll close it up so it's out of the way.
Yeah.
Okay, so put the keys here.
Yeah.
We have to undo and this one.
Yeah.
Do that. Do this one. Pull that off there. You may as well do these at the same time. This one out. This one out. That comes down.
Sweet!
Pull this one. Do it like this so it goes back over. Drop that in that. Pull these down here with those there.
Wait, are you taking that wheel off?
No, the wheel's staying on.
Good.
This is for our hot water system. Put that there so we don't forget it. We've got to put it here, but otherwise when we open that up, it's going to bite us in the bum. We're going to undo the straps. And then to undo that, we have to go back around the other side. And pull these straps through. Throw them up. Safety chain for the kayaks. Fall off on the highway. Pull the strap back through. Yeah, put it. Put that by the tree. Is your hole still there? Hold the china.
struggling?
No. Broken. And from the land of the bay, I thought they would have lasted longer than a few months. It is what it is. So just still opening it up. Almost one-handed.
Hi!
That's done. Strap comes under here. That's done. Tight because it keeps it all inside, square when you open it up. Like that. Right. On this side, We'll do up these five. Duck under this. Three. Four. Zip tie thing out of the way. That's the five rib outs. And come around the front. Mm. Oh, you got static. Oh, so right now it's a little dirty here. And if it's not level, we're gonna put the mat out first, aren't we, Ella? And that way the annex goes on the mat. If you want to hold this for Dad,
okay,
and watch me get the mat out the back.
Okay.
That's our mat from Siggy. Green side goes on the bottom and the grey side goes on top. Normally a two person job, but we'll work it out. Let me do. we have to do these seven. Turn it on. The two ways to do it, either you go under there or you come through here. I just find it easier to pick up. Come over here, open up your hatch, and we turn on the mains pump, press the button. And that's it. This one's a stereo, I'm gonna play some music while we're waiting. 3.6 using 9.1 amps. Close this up so we don't damage it as it inflates.
Not
yet. And we stand back and we watch it. Because when it starts going up, you got to help the annex go up. And once everything's sort of sitting around, then you start picking stuff down.
So when it gets blown up, we have to help it so there isn't any like corner things.
Yep. That way it goes up nice and easy. In the meantime, we get to enjoy the scenery. Some pelicans over there. Bit of shade here, it's a fire pit, some wood we left here last weekend. Got ute full of wood as well, and of course any branches on the ground that you want to go and get, you're welcome to burn those as well. I'm going to stay in the fire pits. What's up, dude? In the car, in the front seat, I'd put them on. And then if you want to, you can start blowing the paddleboard. I've got a paddleboard pump in here. Somewhere. That's our shower tent. That's all our firewood in there. So what I'll do is once this is up, we'll put down the wheels, get it balanced, put the jockey wheel down. I'll actually probably disconnect the ute from the camper because it's pretty hard to get the wood out from there, as you'd imagine. Depends on how you want to do it. It's pretty hot right now, so I might leave it till later on. Get back to the camper. What you looking for? As you can see, the top's starting to get some air in it now. Starting to go up. Just pull this thing a bit more where it needs to be. You can see, there she goes. Starting to get some air in there. Doesn't take too long. It's just about getting it all ready to go. And with the annex on the ground, that way you don't dirty the rest of it. Put your mat down, what are you smiling at? Look, there she goes. So the back's gone up.
Now we just wait for the
front. The rest of the pressure will slowly get in there and pump the rest of it up.
If I got a big cushion couch.
You can always give it a hand if you want to. Popped up. So normally that means we've got a bit of a pressure problem. So let's have a look, Ella, hold that for a second. Actually, you know what, I'll hold it, we're going under here. We go under here, and we'll find out where the blocker gets. Into the side. You know what we'll do, darling?
What?
Might let the air... Oh, we'll just press the button, fuck it. He'll be right. Go! Probably not. Back of the ute. Thank you. You got it? I'm gonna get my phone, Buddha, in the center console of the car.
Hello.
Are you on your way?
Oh.
Are you on your way?
Are you there?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're just coming into Wamuray.
Okay.
And the roadworks.
I was going to say bring the crab pots, but that's all right.
Do you know what? I looked at them.
Yeah, because it's a bit warmer now, so it'd be all right.
Yeah, I'm not going to tune down now because I'm nearly where we're in.
All right.
I looked at them and I thought, oh, we aren't there right now.
Yeah.
I should throw them in, and then I just was like, oh, he won't want to do that.
All good. All right, I'll see you soon.
How much have you done?
Yeah, most of it.
Really? How did you go?
Yeah, it wouldn't go up because I forgot to open the valve up for the annex.
Oh, shit.
So, that's all right. Just stopped it and opened it and then started again. So now I have
and
to do is, I haven't done any straps or anything yet or leveled it out, but I'm close.
What was I going to say to you? Are you just in the same spot?
Yep.
Yeah.
All right, I'll keep going. It's getting hot.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Yeah. Come look before you start blowing it, okay? And turn the stereo on. Up.
What are you recording now?
Haven't stopped yet.
44 minutes. So kind, you know.
No, just leave it. It's not set up yet.
Okay.
Hold that for a second. A little smash of the coke in my blackjack. Don't let this black tie fool you. I'm a thug on roof. A midnight blue. Can you add all that bubble over there for me, the green one? No, I can't move it. Leave where it is. Tell me what's in the middle, okay? Be close. Getting closer?
Yeah. It's in there.
Cool. I like to put these down because I am going to move it, and these do act as a brake. Let out my tubes in here, those sort of things. If hot water system, which will go up here. Okay, we'll do that later on though. Now, safety wise, there's no wind, so I really don't need pegs. I'll probably peg it down later on, but because I don't want snakes in there, we'll close it up. Done. We'll put the things under here still, which we'll go inside and get those, and then we'll come back and strip it around. And then, we'll unhook the car, unload the wood, and go from there. That way, if anything goes wrong, the car's free. I'm going to dick around doing that. Right, put a bump. Yeah. Let's go look at your thing for you. This is a chaos keyboard. Now, to inflate, valve pin up. So Ella would have pumped it all the way up, and then she would have pulled the valve out, and it would have gone straight back down. Now she can sit here and she can pump for the next, what do you reckon, hour, 2 hours, 3 hours?
Probably 2 hours.
Okay, go. Have fun. I'll watch you do two or three. Ready? Not there yet. Not there yet. Not there yet. Put it closer so you don't stretch the cord all the time.
What is it?
Put the pump closer. That's it. And stand on it. It has to be in the green. Good luck. Oh, so this is where we're at. Fridge is out. And adjust the stairs. Pull the barbecue out. Really good in place. Got some place there. And something we found last time was we didn't realise you don't really need it, but there's actually this under here. You can pull that out. This actually comes down. It's taken us 4 months to find that, and obviously you adjust it down to suit. But, then we'll pull all this out. So the adjustment for the lights. Sits like so, this comes up, go in there, these are our plates, sit there, light for the stove. Travel. On, and that's pump number. This is the confusing part. Pump two, which is pump two. I don't know why they've done that. Makes no sense. We turn that on, pump two, turn the water on, and we'll go in here. It's open, so tested.
that ready for the shower. Done. Close it up. Battery life 10%. And here we've got a cup lead. So that's almost set up, putting that leg down. So now we'll get the stairs set up and adjusted, and then realistically all it's left is the wall for the toilet, so it's kind of enclosed. And organised the ute. So here's a door. I'm gonna pin the door back so you can get better access to it. So, let's go get this, and it's got these little buckles on the back here. And we go on the side of the frame here. As you can tell, I'm in no rush. You know, we're here a couple of days. Now the stairs are at a shit angle, so what we do, pull these up. Semi close it back down. Pull these out. So we're going to be on the last hole here. As you can see, it's quite dark. Now, could make your way through it. So we'll start with these ones. This is the way that I pack it up. Okay. Everyone's gonna have their own way of doing things. But it's pretty easy, so I sit in and I start. Now these are gonna go all the way over there. It's easier to just thumb up here to start with. And just go work your way back to them. This is our side, so I can go out there. These are those cushions going to go on the side of the thing as well. I'm using now. There's a random towel there. That's my wife putting stuff in the wrong spot. Right, cushion. Just come back down. This is the table with the Laguna leg on it. Or Lagoon, sorry. Now, one of the last things to do, put it over there. These are our king bed extensions. The stereo just got louder. I've uncovered the speakers. So you can hear me. Turn it down. A solar panel. I'll set that up in a minute. So there-ish, shouldn't fall down. Lagoon table leg, and our two smaller cushions.
table, which we can put outside of the wheels, which gives us a good place to make sandwiches, etc. Now out of the way, pull it back in a little bit just because I don't trust it. Oh, king bed extension. Push it in there. Oh, there is one thing I'm missing there. Under here. More storage. And I need these cushions. And you'll see why shortly. Remember, all this is being done one-handed, so. Jesus Christ. Go easy on me in the comments. They're going to end up going approximately there. So, king's bed extension. One. Two. That up here as well. And table leg can go over there. Big cushion. Big cushion goes over here. Before we do that, let's look under here. Make sure the wires got nothing in there. Good, close it up. Okay, grab our corner cushions. See that gap there? That's where those other little ones are going to go. Put that into play there. Put this part. Go into here. Blankets. So I'll have to get in there shortly. For now, let's get some airflow. We'll fix them up in a minute. I'm not sure if there's a quick one there, see there. It's definitely a two-handed job. Okay. One goes there. This one, the short one. Got to finesse it in the box. Yeah, so, that will go there. We need that one there, which is under here. Done. Lagoon table. there, so that way you can swing it. With this, you just put a ratchet. And we'll grab a table. Table does two things. It goes out of the way so you can get up in the bed. When you're in bed, the table will rotate and sit up in there so you can watch, you know, your TV or iPad or sitting there. But, then of course, eating meals, you bring it back around and you put it in the middle like so. Brilliant idea. Up in there. Out of the way. Now let's go up in here and get up here and we'll wipe that up even more. There's a good breeze coming through the whole thing. And pretty much everything gets rolled up. Can't stress how important it is to have the essential tools. Things like vice grips, multi-grips, screwdrivers, side cutters, a multimeter is a fucking must if you're going off-road, off-grid. You need to find out what's gone wrong if something does go wrong. Keep your basic tools. I'm out here, fill my toilet up, good to go.